that sometimes my show is like a soap opera, but that's another story. But anyway, Mr. Patrick Van Buren can attest to some of the facts of some interesting guests and interesting people we've had in here over the many, many years, and Jim will probably tell you a little bit more about some of those great people. In the meantime, I think we're over here on track.
Nat King Cole.
Nat King Cole here at WPAT.
All the millennials just tuned out.
Is it that Nat King who?
Only the one of the best singers this country ever saw.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
Jack Frost.
Jack Frost nipping your nails. Yuletide carols being sung by choir.
I do have a.
And folks dressed up like Eskimos.
Got a text from Zach Morton right now. Listening, huh?
Yeah. Turkey and some mistletoe.
Take a picture of Ralph with me later. We'll put it on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, no. Please
do that. You got it. First, get one of right up over privacy completely destroyed.
There's nothing private anymore.
With their eyes all aglow.
Oh, yeah.
We'll find it hard to see.
We're going
to
talk to Lily in there.
Tonight.
Yeah, and then play the song after.
They know
the song
that Santa is on his way.
Okay, play it first. Okay, announce it. Okay,
he's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is going to smile.
Right
to see a reindeer.
Let's get a little first.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from one to many. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
We're making a lot of dedications on this show tonight. One of them has to be dedicated to the Mr. Walt Golander. Learned a lot from that man over the years, and Jim can tell you a little story about Walt a little bit later during the show. And we'll be mentioning other people that this show is dedicated to this evening. In the meantime, I want to welcome Lillian Walker Moss to the show this evening. Lillian, it's great to have you here. And as I told you the last time, my mother's name is also Lillian.
Oh, I remember you telling me that.
Yeah. In the meantime, I'm glad that you came down here tonight. What would you like to everyone who's listening out there, which we're actually getting text messages from Hawaii, one from Australia, we have one from New Zealand, another, of course, here in the tri-state area. Our signal reaches all of Connecticut and the five boroughs and Jersey, and since it's a New York radio station. But it's great to have you back here this year, because you bring a wonderful insight and dimension to this program. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Where would you like to begin this evening in terms of what you're doing between now and 2018? Is there some things that you'd like to share with us that we don't know already?
Well, I'm working with a singing group. Many people have heard of us, but some who haven't. I'm working with a singing group called the Supergirl Group, and that consists of five ladies from who had hit records from famous groups in the 60s, and that would be Margaret Williams of the Cookies, Louise Murray of the Janettes and the Hearts, Nanette Licari of the Reparata and the Delrons, and Beverly Warren of the Raindrops, and of course myself of the Exciters.
When did you first meet these ladies?
I knew Margaret's from way back in the day.
Oh, good.
But I think I met Nanette first. I went to a concert in Metro Tech, and I met Nanette, and I saw her again in the movies one day, come to find out she lives close by me. So after that, we became friends, and from there, she introduced me to Barbara Harris of the Toys, who she was good friends with, and Louise Murray. And then we went to John Clemente's book release party, and I met Beverly. So that's how we all got to be friends, and we started our singing group.
Mm. What would you like to say about the song we're about ready to play, Tell Him, by the Exciters? Mm-hmm.
Well, what I would like to say about Tell Him is that who knew that it was gonna make a hit, first of all? Like, our first time out, it made a smash hit. And it's lasted so long, they put it in, like, we're up to 8 movies now that it's in. And I'm told that they're still playing on the radio every once in a while. So who knew that?
Hey, we play it all the time here at WPAT.
Yeah, so that's a surprise.
And you know, our young audience, we have between our ages of 20 and 65 plus. Mm-hmm. A lot of the 20-year-olds are asking to hear a lot of the 50s music and 60s music.
Yeah.
And while a lot of the other stations don't play because of various factors in terms of going after the potential advertisers, mm-hmm. We'll still play all of the great songs because we do believe that the great music of the 50s and 60s should live on forever and ever and ever.
Thank you, because I'm trying to promote a movement to keep our music alive.
Mm-hmm. Well, you can always count on the Jim Petracca Productions and yeah. The Teddy Smith Show here at WPAT to keep it alive.
Yeah, that's why I wouldn't miss this annual Christmas party for anything in the world.
What are you doing for Christmas this year? Do you have any plans?
Well, I'm going to my daughter lives in Georgia and my granddaughter lives in Virginia, so we're all getting together at my daughter's house in Georgia.